Hey guys, sorry for being late and keeping you waiting for this video. In this tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how you can achieve this result. To create architectural design, what you really need is a floor plan. You can create by using Autodesk Homestyler, or if you are good in Blender, you can create that here too. So first switch to top orthographic view and select the image reference from the menu. After that, select the image floor plan you want to load in. Now add a box in the scene, and while in edit mode, go to the overlay and check the edit length in the measurement tab. After that, go to the scene tab and then change the unit scale to imperial. Now just pick one value from the floor plan and scale the box until it has the same value. After that, select the floor plan and scale it up to match the box value. You can use the cursor pivot point, which will help you to match it easily with the floor plan. I have set the height value of the wall to about 13 feet. It's better to know about average heights and width of the room, doors, windows from real life scenario. It will help you build your model fast. You can search on Google to know the values. I have set the wall width value to about 6 inches. After that, just use the edge loop and slide it to the end of the edges, and then press G and use the numpad keys with XYZ axis to define the width of the wall. It's a simple trick, but it can add pace to your work. After following the floor plan, you will get this result. For the background and lighting, go to the World tab and select Environment Texture for the color and select HDR you want for the scene. To rotate HDR, use Mapping under Vector and generate texture coordinate for the vector again. Rotate the HDR on Z axis and leave it on what looks interesting for the scene. Focus on light that is covering the faces so you may know how it will give shadows later after baking. After that, check ambient occlusion and screen space reflection and play with the values. I wanted to make a night scene. For that, I have decreased the gamma value and slightly increased the exposure value. To hide the background, I have used the sphere mesh with emissive material with same material setting as I had used for the previous one. But this time I have used the texture coordinate object under the vector tab so that I can rotate it inside the 3D workspace. For the exterior glass material, select the faces and assign material to it. After assigning the material, put the roughness value to 0 and change metallic value to 0.5. Under the setting tab, check the screen space reflection and use alpha blind for the blinding mode. You can use 0.1 to 0.6 refraction value for the glass. After that, check the reflection under screen space reflection tab and just increase the transmission value to 1 under material tab. For the interior lighting, I have used area lights with checked custom distance with slightly yellowish red color. If your exterior light have dominant blue color, try to use opposite color in the color wheel so that you can get better contrast for your scene. After setting the lights to different rooms, I started to add different objects like walls, chairs, and tables for the scene. For the global illumination, you will need a radiance volume for individual room, and some will be placed outside of the house where you think light will bounce. It's important to know that the inner box of the radiance volume is the border of the light from which light will start to fall off, or you can say soften to the outer box of the volume. You can even define the fall off of the light from the radiance volume tab. After setting the radiance volume, bake the light. Don't hesitate to play with the color management gamer or exposure after you are done with the baking, as it helps you to create better scenario environmental lighting. After lighting interior, select the pool surface and assign material to it. To create water for the pool, select slightly blue color with zero roughness and increase the subsurface scattering value to 1 and increase the metallic value to 0.6. Then check subsurface transparency inside the setting tab. Don't forget to check the subsurface scattering from the scene tab. After assigning the material, you can add area lights inside the pool with slight rotation making angle of 45. It's up to your creative choices. You can change the scale of the area lights. After that, select the floor of the pool and assign material to it. You can change the roughness to get reflection of the lights. To create water effects, you can add musgrave texture to roughness node. Then add texture coordinate and plug the object node to the musgrave vector. Play with the scale value of the musgrave texture. Add color ramp between the musgrave and the roughness node to get more control over the values. After that, play with the details of musgrave and the color ramp color values to get the desired results. For the grass, select the floor faces and assign material to them with green color. At this moment, I felt that the area of grass plane will be in shadows, so I added area lights to the stairs with emissive plane material. To create grass, I have created two planes of meshes with slightly curve to them with taper at the tip. After that, duplicate and separate grass area from the floor to which you want to add grass. After separating, go to the particles tab, click on the plus button to add particles to it, change the frame start and end value to 0, then under the render tab, select render as to object. And in object tab, click the picker to pick the mesh you want for the particle to display. Then increase the scale value to increase the size of the grass and also play with the randomize scale value to randomize the scale. And then check rotation and play with the phase and randomize phase to have randomized rotation of the grass. After that, just increase the emitter value to have more grass on the selected fields. Add material to the modeled grass. It will update the other grass particle, give it color, and add slight yellowish scattering color with 0.1 to 0.5 scattering value. For the tree, I have used Blender built-in tree generator plugin. You need to go in the preference tab, which is under edit tab. In the add-ons tab, type sapling, then apply check to it and save it to preference tab. You can get the tree by pressing Shift A and then go to Curve and select Sapling Tree Generator. I have used the tree for background, it adds more details to the scene. After that, I have added the reflection cube map and scale it up to the background sphere to get the reflection of the sphere. You need to increase clipping end to 10,000, which will be present under the reflection cube map tab. After that, position the cube map higher than the architecture so that it can capture the background sphere, but not only the walls. After that, rotate or scale the sphere as you want, then click bake light. It will bake the light as well as the reflection. I needed to do that as updated several outdoor lights. After that, if you want to get more reflection on the glass, then select the glass material and then slightly increase the metallic value. The walls were looking dull, so I added the area lights with long width matching the width of the wall, with color matching to the interior lights. For the volumetric light, use cube mesh, scale the mesh and assign material to it. Remove the surface material and add volume scatter under volume settings. Don't forget to check the volumetric from the scene tab. Then decrease the density to 0.01 and play with the anisotropic value to define the light volume more or less. In the end, I did some changing to the windows and materials of the walls and used the pool inner surface material on the floor and play with it to get the results. I have added more meshes inside the interior. Some of them were from my old projects. The bed was the only mesh which was downloaded from Blender Swap due to the some time issues. I didn't model it. You can also use downloaded model as far as it doesn't have the copyright issues. I was unable to upload video, so for that I'm going to share this project file with you guys for free. You can download from the link in the description box. You can support me by pledging me on my Patreon page so that I can make more videos for you guys. Subscribe and like, and thanks for watching.